Sick, terminal, debilitating, dying. What do you imagine when you hear these words? Like most people, you may be picturing a great loss of life and of health. Why must we resign to disease? Why must we stop living? No, this is not the end of health as we know it. Let's explore a different perspective. Born in 1933 in Tennessee, Margaret Heumann received an undergraduate degree in home economics, which would have been her career, but life had greater plans for Ms. Heumann. The life-changing moment for Margaret was when her mother was diagnosed with ALS. Margaret had a moment of clarity when she was the primary caregiver for her mother. She realized that this was her calling and pursued a nursing degree from the University of Tennessee. Margaret worked alongside nursing theorist Martha Rogers, whose theory of unitary human beings provided the foundation to health as expanding consciousness. To help you understand Margaret Heumann's theory of health as expanding consciousness, I am going to delve into some major concepts. The concepts I will explore are system, which are human beings, consciousness, health, pattern, environment, and nursing. In Margaret Heumann's theory, she refers to a human being as a system. Note the reference in the following explanation. Heumann used the concept of consciousness as the capacity of the system, or human being, to interact with its environment. According to Merriam-Webster's dictionary, the definition of consciousness is perceiving, apprehending, or noticing with a degree of controlled thought or observation. For Margaret Heumann's theory, consciousness has a different meaning than the one we are used to. Margaret Heumann defines consciousness as the information of the system, or human being, the capacity of the system to interact with the environment. As nurses, we will want to foster a higher level of consciousness in our patients, but also in ourselves. Instead of viewing a disease as something negative, we have to view it as something that helps us evolve along with our patient, moving us toward a higher consciousness. This picture, that is based on Prigogine's theory of dissipative structure, depicts well how a disease or disruption can lead us to a higher level of consciousness. In the beginning, we are in our normal, predictable routine. We meet a giant fluctuation, which could be disease or some type of disruption. We go through a time of disorganization and uncertainty, and in the end, we emerge with a new, higher level of consciousness. To most people, health is thought of as the absence of disease, disease being undesirable and health being the objective. In Margaret Heumann's theory, health is defined as the expansion of consciousness. The objective is still to have good health, but health is something different than what we are used to. In Margaret Heumann's theory, health is deemed as something that includes both disease as well as non-disease. Disease is an important part of the theory and may well bring about health. As Heumann states, sickness can provide a kind of shock that reorganizes the relationships of the human being's pattern in a more harmonious way. Like the process in the diagram on the previous slide illustrated, our patients could be faced with disease. Our job is to help them discover new rules by which to live by, because the old rules won't work anymore. The end result is a higher level of consciousness for both the patient and us as we evolve right along with our patient and both come out of the circumstance with a better quality of interaction with our environment. A simple way to explain pattern is the ups and downs of life. In life, there are times when we have harmony and stability and predictability. However, to evolve to a higher level of consciousness, we have to go through times of disharmony and uncertainty. As nurses, we enter a relationship with our patient in which we both evolve and grow. Our task in that relationship includes recognizing these patterns, relating to the pattern in a sincere way, and helping our patient discover the new rules of the higher level of organization. Environment. In Margaret Heumann's theory of health as expanding consciousness, Heumann states that environment is undivided wholeness of the universe. The main function of a nurse is to care for and be present for the client as the client's pattern becomes more clear. The nurse should help clients utilize the power within themselves while they go through a personal crisis by being present and available. Eventually, the client's pattern will reveal itself. The nurse is in a position to help the client recognize the emerging life pattern and move forward. So can we apply this theory outside of nursing? The answer to that question is yes. A person does not have to experience an illness to expand to a higher level of consciousness. The theory asserts that every person in every situation, no matter how disordered and hopeless it may seem, is part of the universal process of expanding consciousness. So that was a lot to absorb in a few minutes. Still a little confused on the theory? Don't worry, some of you may need an example of this theory in action. So I will leave you with a clip from the movie You're Not You.
It says here your most recent place of employment was Red Lobster.
Kind of padded that one.
Have you ever cared for someone suffering from a major degenerative illness?
Not really.
Okay, well, it was young
lady.
What
did you mean by not really?
This woman is a nightmare.
You're actually responsible for another person's life.
She doesn't make me feel like a patient.
I know that it's important to you,
but I just want to get back to the way things were.
Experimental drugs.
I am going to die.
I remember how the promise breaks, and I don't want to be the one who takes.
I don't want to be here.
A retirement home?
This isn't the life he built. I'm the one who got sick, not him.
That's it. Honey, unless those sippy cups are laced with tequila, we're out of here. What are you doing here?
I'm doing something positive.
No one in my life has ever done that for me.
You want to die, and you know I won't let you.
I want to scream.
But I just want you to know that I'm sorry.
I love you so much.
I don't know what I'd do without you.
Words.